头对我很大的，是还是轮的，能发现我，还有很多的人跟我一样的肿瘤，我跟我一样，醒了以后，我肯定会来通知他。
Huang Chunsai has spent his adult life in hiding. Now he's about to take a journey he hopes will change him forever. This is the story of China's Elephant Man. Huang Chunsai has lived all his life in Dashu, a tiny village in the hills of southeastern China. Many have left to work in the new factories in the south, where they can earn more in 1 month than a farmer here makes all year. In 3 days, Huang will leave his village for an operation on the tumors that threaten his life. Huang's younger sister is 25. She spent the last 6 years working at a sports shoe factory.
I didn't want to leave my job, but my parents needed me to come home.
She's given up her career to come home and care for Huang.
It's really tough caring for Huang. Although my little brother is here, he doesn't do a very good job.
Huang's brother, or Little Huang as he's called, is 23. He also had a job in a trainer factory, but has come home to help care for Huang. He has a 3-year-old son, the legacy of his brief marriage to a factory girl.
It was hard to choose between my wife and my family. But at the end of the day, my family comes first.
For his father, the burden of caring for Huang is overwhelming.
Huang may have had to endure the pain from the tumors, but as a father, I feel even more pain. Ever since he has had the tumor, I've been unhappy all the time.
Huang's father is 62 and suffers from a liver condition. Increasingly unable to farm, he makes noodles, which he sells in the nearby market.
Huang receives the best of everything while we get what's left. This makes me miserable.
Normally, when a child grows up, he has to look after his parents in old age. For us, it's the opposite. We have to look after him because he's disabled.
Huang is keenly aware of the burden he has been. The responsibility of caring for parents in old age traditionally falls on the eldest son. Unless his forthcoming surgery is successful, Huang knows it's a duty he will never fulfill. There are no childhood photos of Huang. His parents were too poor to own a camera, but he appeared a normal, healthy child. When Huang was four, he developed a swelling on his face and was diagnosed with neurofibromatosis, or NF, a genetic condition affecting roughly 1 in 2,500. NF was thought to be the condition suffered by Joseph Merrick, Victorian London's elephant man. But it's now believed Merrick suffered from the very rare Proteus syndrome. Although there's no cure for NF, surgery can sometimes be used to control the tumours. Many sufferers lead normal lives. But Huang's case is extreme.
The doctors back then said having an operation was too risky. Secondly, we had no money to finance an operation. I had no way out.
As Huang grew, so did his tumours. Drawing nutrition from his body, they've stunted his growth and left his bones undeveloped. Causing his spine to buckle, they have made him a hunchback and restrict his breathing and speech.
Being a mother, to see that my son was disabled made me very sad.
Now, Huang's only chance of a future lies in an operation he hopes will liberate him from his tumours before they kill him. In 2 days, Huang Chunsai will say goodbye to his family and the village that's been his home for the last 31 years. He suffers from an extreme form of neurofibromatosis, and the tumors that destroyed his body now threaten his life. Now, Huang's only chance of a future lies 300 miles away in Guangzhou, the heart of southern China's manufacturing boom of the last decade. Fuda Cancer Hospital's Professor Xu has treated other so-called Elephant Man cases. But nothing prepared him for Huang's condition.
I was shocked. I'd never seen such a massive tumor.
Last year, Xu went to Huang's village. The combined weight of his tumors was 25 kilograms, half his body weight. Despite the risks involved, Xu offered Huang surgery to help ease his suffering, and last summer performed a preliminary operation on Huang at Fuda Hospital.
I'm sure no other doctor had ever touched Huang before. I took a firm hold of his tumor and found where it connected to his body. If I could cut this, then he could be cured.
Tomorrow, Huang will return to the hospital in Guangzhou to face an operation far more dangerous than the first. There's been a death in the village. Huang's next-door neighbor has passed away. To feed mourners at the funeral, relatives slaughter a pig. For Huang, it will be only the second time he has left the village in 26 years.
Of course, we all hope that the doctors will cure him. If the operation isn't successful, all we can do is look after him for the rest of his life.
I'm not worried. I'm confident modern medical technology can cure him.
Thank you.
我跟你说。
Afraid of being made fun of, Huang left school at the age of 12 and became a virtual recluse.
My husband and I had to leave him alone during the day. We are farmers and had to work in the fields. Huang would say, "Mommy, I'm sorry, I can't make money for you." Every time he said that, I got so upset.
I remember playing with Huang and the little Huang when we were kids. We would catch fish and frogs, and then would go home and cook them. For most in the village, Huang has been simply accepted as a permanent fixture in the local shop. Huang has left home just twice in his entire life. But word of the reclusive elephant man has spread beyond his village.
Some men came and offered me money to put Huang in the traveling circus. I said he's a human being, not a performing monkey. I would not allow him to be made into a clown.
Huang
It's time for Huang to leave his village for the operation he needs to save his life. I'll be so relieved if he comes home safe. My poor child. It's a 12-hour journey from Huang's village to the city of Guangzhou. It's midnight by the time Huang and his sister arrive at the hospital. This will be his home for the next 2 weeks, as doctors prepare him for the surgery that could cure or kill him. While Huang prepares for the surgery his life depends on, Tests reveal his condition is rapidly deteriorating.
We did a CT scan to see what was going on inside his skull. You can see that the tumor has already invaded his brain. His left eye has completely gone, and the tumor has invaded his throat, which you can see here. If it continues to grow, it will stop his breathing and kill him.
In addition to threatening his brain and destroying his left eye, the CT scans make it clear that Huang's tumor is starting to strangle him.
The tumor is making it really hard for Huang to sleep at the moment.
Even at private hospitals, it's customary for relatives to provide the food for patients. Huang's sister will cook for him throughout his stay.
When I was a teenager, I used to dream that Huang would suddenly recover, become a normal man, tall and handsome. Now I hope that dream will come true.
Huang's future is now in the hands of the surgeons and Professor Xu.
There are lots of difficulties with Huang Chuncai's operation. Firstly, the tumor has a rich supply of blood with many veins, which we have to stop from bleeding. The second problem is the inside of his mouth, which will be cut a lot, so we have to remake his mouth. The final problem is his ear. It is still connected to his brain. We can't block it or cut it off, so we have to find a way to keep his ear canal open. It's the day of the operation. Huang's mother, brother, and nephew have made the journey from their village to be with him for the surgery he's waited 26 years for. Huang and the doctors know
that its outcome is in no way certain. Huang's tumor is so large, the doctors worry its removal could cause fatal hemorrhage. And his vital organs are so weak, they could fail under the stress of the operation.
The greatest fear for any surgeon is a patient dying on the table. In Huang's case, every stage of the operation presents a risk to his life.
The first step is to block the veins in Huang's tumor and stop the blood flow. Then we freeze the tumor and turn it into a giant ice ball. Then the tumor can be cut out.
Cryoablation was developed in America to treat prostate cancer. It's never been used to treat a tumor the size of Huang's.
We have never done this kind of surgery before. Every step is an experiment. It's like walking a tightrope. You never know when you might fall.
When I was young, other kids used to laugh at Huang. They used to call him Elephant Man. I didn't stop them. I think I was ashamed to be his brother. Then, when I left home, I missed him so much. At night, I used to cry myself to sleep.
After the 2-hour operation, surgeons have successfully removed over 5 kilograms of tumor. Now in intensive care, Huang's bleeding heavily and in a critical condition.
看看心跳的变化啊，嗯嗯，看看心脏一下，呼，呼啊，把这痛啊，好好好好，配合配上好配上好。把它摇平一点，扶起来。那行，哇，这里都发凉了，松开还好，要不然那个血，不回流啊，这块组织缺血坏死了，要命。Huang
Chunsai's life is hanging in the balance. The next 24 hours are crucial. Hwang Chun-sai has had the operation he has waited all his life for. After 24 hours in intensive care, doctors allow his mother and brother to see him.
It's so upsetting seeing him like this, bandaged up and unable to speak. But I felt him squeeze my hand. He knew I was there.
Han Jianzhen, 懂不懂啊? 我是徐院长吗? 看得见我吗? 啊? 握握手, 哎, 好,
因为他流了那个皮片肯定会渗出来很多。是是是,
今天一天好吧, 徐院好吗?
徐院这一直都是挺好的。白天没用就可以了。
If there are no complications, he should be fine up to 2 weeks. He should be home for Chinese New Year. Once he's fully recovered, I'm planning another operation. After that, he'll be able to live like a normal person.
It's 6 weeks after Huang's operation. Southern China endured its worst winter on record. Now farmers are busy preparing for spring. Huang's village has been without electricity for nearly a month. His family have gone to collect him from Guangzhou, leaving his mother at home.
I really hope he's recovered and strong enough to work. That would make me really happy.
She has not seen her son for a month and a half. Today, Hwang Chun-sai is coming home. Huang knows he is still a long way from achieving his greatest wish.
He is still living with a tumor and dealing with a lot of pain. Sometimes my brother feels so low that he doesn't want to carry on.
Huang has 3 months to wait before the prospect of any further surgery.
Every day my brother is alive is a blessing for me.
Oh, 我才会近视，因为还有很多人，还有很多的人跟我一样的肿瘤，我跟我一样的肿瘤，因为跟我一样肿瘤的话，我也会染上这条这恐惧是真，这恐惧是真，如果治好。